Thank you for working, thank you for coming for this morning. For some of you, this morning, but for us, it's Shabbat. But before I comment, like we always do on this episode, maybe if your friends are not going to book Abraham. It was fun when it's a book of Abraham, if you think that we might listen. To deliver the message to the children. For years, the children has been disappointed. I'm upon this radio. I want to lead that man's name in the camera. Establishing to gather the children of Abraham back from the four corners of the earth. Like the phoenix, my rise, the bone rise from the dead. And the army is marched from the four corners of the earth. But before I proceed, I said, we probably have to, I know that you already prayed. You already prayed the prayer for another hour. I'm going to make it so quick because always the ritual to bring. He doesn't share his glory. It doesn't matter what you do. It doesn't matter what you are, whoever you call. To go to God, you have to define his glory to anybody. That is number one rule. Thank you for anything for another issue of God and my effort to be over. Because you talk a little bit slowly. Very, very kindly, huh?
Because he doesn't understand, he doesn't speak English.
No me necesito hablar o cerrar muchas veces datos de capital. Ahí está López en el éxito, ahí está el Jackson. He has a different language called a different dialect. No me necesito that language. I'm sorry. So those of us that don't answer and cannot speak their Igbo or any other of a different language, I encourage everyone of us to learn our language. That's how we can communicate. Listen, Billy, first of all, it's morning, my evening, but some of you say morning, but before I commence, I want to thank those of us. Let us have a sit-at-home for the October 1st for the show called Nigeria. There is nothing to write about that, but that means it's a geographical expression by Led Abokunia Wolo. Nigeria was never a country. It was a larger company, and then independence, and then transferred to a new public entity. They are building an institute. And then they pick up a couple of people from this region that come, and they form a business about their forming everyone there. But if the winner, my role of this is good, when the people take back their power. But before I move forward, I want to thank you. There is a protest going on in Rwanda. Therefore, women worldwide, they have done a marvelous work. Like what our mothers did in Ghana. I will personally thank them for those who prepare their time, travel all far to be there to protest. Not those that are causing confusion in IPOB, but those that indicate these are the people we serve. They are indeed our Lord, because they have that consolation at heart. They want the good for every one of us. I will not thank them. They have done marvelous work. I will respect them. Not those that, the agent of darkness, the daughters of Jezebel, are too, trying to destroy what we are feeling. They will never see the door of the light. The apostle is a pit of hell. And they will be destroyed. And the history will never remember them. Anybody that comes to bring their son down in IPOB, sorry is the name of that person. Without any apology. We do not care who you are. Here we speak the truth. It doesn't matter what you consider to be the truth. Because what you consider to be the truth is money. Money is what you consider to be the truth. Second, envy and gossip is what you consider to be the truth. There is here. None of those things move us. We say it the way it is, without any fear or favor. That is the difference. Today, my point is, what I wanted to say is, I have a couple of messages I want to deliver to our people. As we rejected October 1st, we have rejected Nigeria in every way, in every church. And they know it. Just a question of time. Our subconsciousness has proven. But we cannot take blame for this. The Chukwuka Kadiam is in making. All the sacrifice, all our heroes that died, that we can't remember it, aspect of atonement, all these things. And we must as well acknowledge the land, the people that are before us, the owners of our land, and that is behind each year. We will never abandon our home. That is one thing. And this is the problem we as a people, as the Biafrans are having. We convert our own culture, but other people keep their culture, still keep whatever religion they have. Religion and culture is two different things. That is my topic this morning. I don't want us to mix it. We cannot replace one with our leader. That is the greatest mistake we are making as a people. Christianity is a beautiful thing. Every other religion is a beautiful thing. But our culture is not there. It's not a supplement for religion. Religion is not a culture. It's a two separate things. You do not mix one or another. And for that reason, we must acknowledge they live before us, they are our ancestors. We know that you have your children, right? Your children, I don't know your age, but whatever age you are, maybe your children already have their children. So you die. So your grandchildren already have an ancestor, so you become an ancestor. You have lived before them. So we acknowledge those that died before us in that land. We live here. We live before we can. And make sure the land we are holding. In every country you go, for example here in Australia, they acknowledge it in every day of their life. When I meant that, what I meant is, I'm talking about Australian government, whether state or local government, it doesn't matter which level of the government. In their email, they are sending email, they said in their email at the bottom, we acknowledge traditional owners of the land, present and the past. We respect them. In their first world, their things are moving forward. On your own, it's a devil, it's evil. You see that something is wrong with you, that is thinking about it. Others are feeling just, their own is evil. When you come around, say yours is evil. That is part of your calamity. So, as we continue, the African Restoration, we are on a journey. And this journey, we need to be able to learn as we continue on this journey. Because the history has a way of repeating itself. Like I said the last week, that we said it was like the world that one day away than 40 years. Just between Egypt and Israel. They are neighbors. It's not like you are coming from Antarctica to the Middle East. They are just a neighbor, but it took them 40 years. Now we look at our earth. we are in our land. From the seat of power, Abuja, to our area of neighborhood, how many kilometers? We have been trying to live in that culture for how many years? Now, when you stand back and look, who is bringing this agenda? Who is preventing us from not going forward? We discover it's we are in our own making. We are our own downfall. We are the people holding ourselves down, not the foreigners. The only what foreigners do is that they provide the logistics. If you look back, if you go back to 1912, when I was to go for the same thing. It's our own people that come in Buddha. And the one other place, use it and one China attack technology. And then, backed by the British, for the third line, that's our own people. They provided we from the ground, crush and kill our own and destroy our own civilization. And then after that, 4 years later, they amalgamate us.
1914.
So they destroy what we have, and they join us together. And before that, we were a very prosperous nation. They were jealous of us. The Arab Confederation ran for over 400 years. We tried with the Portuguese, name it, even the British, even Germans. The territory stretched out as far and beyond. That was when Chukwukabo was before, and that was when we were committing all the atrocities. But the death have already said that we are going to go to captivity and pray for the sins we have committed. And they used the local to build it with the backing of the foreigners, and that is today. Biafra is here. Only if you can see in the spirit, all we have to be is on the most confident where we are. My encouragement to every one of us, those that believe in work, is we continue to do what we are asking. Mazen Namikano has run the rest. As they said in the beginning, who shall I send? Many he has sent to redeem his children. Now our leader Mazen Namikano says, send me, I will come and do the job. And when the time called, he abandoned everything and picked up this cross. He traveled the four corners of the earth and raised the army of Chukwukabo like the phoenix. Our leader has done everything he can. He has brought our subconscious life by the grace of Chukwukabo. What left for us is to continue to march into that our destination, that is the earth. And we follow the instruction. One thing that does, and I could do with all this, is to sell this Biafran resurrection. I repeat, one thing does, under the leadership of Mazen Namikano, and the Mazen Namikano will not do, is to sell or betray Biafra resurrection. But if anybody go outside this and start following any other person or group, then the rest are sure you will be betrayed and sold out. Because in everything we do, the enemy will come. You know, when we talk about that, we thought that devil is a spirit that you cannot see. But well, that is false. Devil is a human being. He breathed like one of us. He talked like one of us. He's living in our midst. We communicate daily prayer like with them. They are our brothers, they are our sisters. There is nothing extraordinary about it. As I said last week, we are just a spirit expressing a physical body. Our body is just a flesh. It's only when you take that flesh, you go in there, you can see who truly, who they are. That is why one should never be surprised. When somebody he or she knows and needs something extraordinary that he or she cannot imagine, because you cannot see beyond what you can see. That is why we see all this confusion coming from in every angle. Since our leader was arrested, trying to confuse the rule to those people that we follow them, because they have gone out of track. Our leader established a setup IQB and put doors. Doors is a collective set of people. No one can corrupt or bribe us. Our leader always said his prayers. Before we came, there was nothing like us, and by the time we come, there will be nothing like us. He knows the reason why he said that. So when you see people saying that is corrupt, as I said last week, I am just a real beside our head. If you see people saying that, know exactly they are the people who harm and destroy the work of every one of us. Some of these people have never touched their homeland. Some of these people are in exile. Some of these people are too just beyond them for one crime or another. This is one thing we love. We should let excuse me. Whatever you want to do, whether it's in whether they are from, then it's not true. We have one source of information. Anything you are hearing, people going under their bed, making no deals, making all manners of things, they are just doing that because they are doing the bidding of the masters. They are the servant of the Jezebel. They are the servant of the devil, trying to deceive the children of God, trying to hold them back from preventing them from reaching their destination. The question is, are you going to listen to them? Are you going to rise above them? And then Jesus on this said, gossip it. I know we have only one source of command and control. It's not you. And everything about that will be intact. When we are saying, said, those that planted the devil, agent, planted in our midst, for a day like this to come up. It wasn't an accident. All this is where I need to talk up. Those are your trust. You thought that they are part of what we are doing. And the prophets and they will show their color, and that's what they are doing. They are coming and showing their color to deceive. That is exactly what is going on. They come with all manners of sweet word, telling you, putting on a leader, saying Shalom, Elohim, all manners of things, trying to impersonate to be like our leader. Sheepishly, those who do not have a leader, who cannot differentiate, I don't know how to describe them, but they start to believe it. They start to listen to these people. I will tell you this evening, if you continue to listen to these people, they will deliver you from reaching your destination. Just like you have worked so hard over the years, labored, just for the time for you to receive your reward. Turn on, come from your wicked, and see you miss it, and then you stop on your back there. And mind you, these people are not doing it freely. They are on a contract of $1 million. Which we soon will discover exactly the amount that is involved. But what we know is, we were warned a couple of weeks after our leader was arrested that the Zoo government gave out money to destabilize IPOB from waiting. What I mean waiting is from inside, not from outside. So if you sat back and look at what has been happening, it's happening from inside. Use your teeth and count your power. All the accusations, as I said last week, there is no single truth or justification to back it up. What I mean is, when you take the matter to court, to file it to court, to provide the evidence before we assign a judge to you, it doesn't have any single merit. It's just mere gossip from people who are actually doing the job of the agents. And they use the money to recruit a lot of people. Few people who have been giving data. Few people from a group. Few people who are giving laptops and equipment. And other people, they cannot speak. Like we say, our leader, I remember how our leader said, he wanted to start that, or was it, he said, and then, my family will do. So, in terms of so much blood and money given to these people, they open their mouth, they cannot speak. Because they are compromised. Because of the material thing. For you to do a freedom fund, it doesn't mean you must be rich. It means that you must be content. Content is you are happy with what you have. But what we are seeing is hungry, downshot people who tend to destroy the work of Marx and mankind, bringing confusion. But what they told them is that those who love listening to passive surely go and pay this attention. But the good thing is not everyone listening to passive. That is what is happening. They are trying day and night formulating all manners of lies, concocting everything possible. When we ask for proof and we give us evidence, they say, oh, you showed our leader, you are part of the people that stole them. But indeed, these people are the actual, the people that sold our leader. They send our leader money, they pay for where our leader is, so they know exactly the address where our leader was. And organize everything, they turn around and then start. You know, all it takes is a couple of weeks, most things will start unveil. You start seeing it like black and white. Now, that's why, you know, I'm sorry, there are genuine ones of them. That is why I do not respect anyone that come up all the way from nowhere say that I am a pastor, I am a bishop, I am about this and that. I'm sorry, there are genuine ones. But my first impression is that I don't have any regard to who you are. That's why some of them, they can use money and buy some of them. They start saying their prophecy. Before our leader was arrested, they even brought the other force to pray that somebody in us is going to betray our leader, a woman and others. Without us knowing, these people have already planned those things greatly. So, they talk up. So they push it, pay the money, and then wait it. And what happened? They say, yeah, amen, prophecy. What is the name of that who plays God? In fact, he must come out to confess. That's a good prophet. He must come out to confess what he did. Otherwise, whatever is you receive, because Jehovah is a spirit. The only way you come out of this person, because you have to come out and expose and explain the money they gave and everything. Because all of you think that you can stop the work of Chukwuka Kajam. Nobody can. This is Biafran project. It's written, we won. Nothing is going to change it. So my advice to people is anybody that is coming with all this false information, telling you this or that, our leader just said 3 million has been in the first month or so, and they're saying all manners of this. All those things they are talking about, I told you adults, they all of them are false. Those people that are bringing you such information, they are the actual individuals that are paid to destroy IPOP. Yes, they are the agents paid to come and destroy IPOP. IPOP is in fact. For those people that are coming, sending all these messages, making all this audio, talking this, talking that, against IPOP, they are actually the agents that pay to destabilize IPOP for wicked. Because they thought that they are going to succeed. But they don't know they are eating a brick wall.
That is the fact. Because all their evidence they have, they always have a meeting with the daughters of Jezebel part 2 from America. And with the person they use, they want to go to IPS, they go to the broadcast, all of them commerce and then carry on this assignment. And with their cohorts. So we want to rise and change these people who are aware. Like we always do in IPOB. We did the knowledge anywhere they can, it's our duty to make sure we scatter them. That is our duty. Nobody is going to take away their people from us. We're almost there. We must guide IPOB with jealousy. Nobody should come near. Change them away. Tell them who they are. And they will disappear. Like what is happening in the zoo, they are killing our people, saying that IPOB is killing, IPOB is a peaceful protest, and a peaceful organization. We do not kill anyone. We have no arms, we have no weapons. All we have is truth coming out of our mouth. And that is why, the more you hold our leader, the more the zoo continues to sink. I repeat, the more you hold that man, it's very, very dangerous, as you guys controlling it. Have you not seen the situation has even gone beyond? This is why he was arrested. Anyway, you will not see that country completely destroyed. Everyone he has said has come to pass. And more is still to come. And Peter Yako, I've said this before, he does come again, the person will come again. If you love yourself, run away from that case. That is all I will say. I will just stop here. Because as I've said previously, all the people, all the cabals of Fulani saw the Zulus that cooperating with the evil organization, selling their own people. All the Fulani cabals that are working with them, those that said therefore will not come there, have all died. And the more you continue to cooperate with our people, the difference, the more the death will come upon you. Do not listen to these people, they do not plan well for you. All they want is to work for money. At your expense, try to work for Nigeria together, you cannot. You are losing your own people every day. If you like, continue. If you want more to use, all of you will continue to die like a chicken. These people are deceiving you, their own death will come later on. But right now, it's you, the Fulanis, that are holding the gas and shall not die. All of you will be dying one after the other. Understand this. Study the statics. I mean, study that, analyze the chart. The death that has been coming between all of you. That is the fact. You cannot stop it. This is beyond, it's no human being what is happening at the moment. It's the Biafran spirit, the Biafran, that land has risen. It's in control. That is why we cannot stop it at home on Monday. The spirit has gone into our people, nobody can stop it at home on Monday. All it takes is to add another one more day, that things will continue from there. They will realize it and know that there is nothing that can salvage what left. One left is to let them go. So all of you will have peace. But if you said no, you think there is money, you will die without enjoying that money. Money is the material, because money can come, money can go. Everything is not about money. The people have cried, said, we need to go and worship our God. We said we do not need that for you. All we want is to be free. So watching people gathering truth and in honesty, he thought that we are joking. Continue to hold our leader. Continue to hold your heart. And continue to see what is going to be falling on that zoo. Before I hand back to you, my dear beloved, I want to say this to our people. We must rise up. We are ready. Those that are listening to gossips, those that are listening to false information, you have source of information, Radio Biafra. As I said last week, whenever our leader left, he said he wants somebody that will speak like our leader. Get us somebody like him. Get us somebody that is talking to me. Are you stupid? Are you crazy? Are you muted? I don't know the word to use to describe you. Go and listen to his previous broadcast. You do not replace their leader. That is why we have all these people case in our land. We do God and people come for two leaders. We said we want him. Today that's why all these calamities are befalling us. He sent us to the regional, bring us to the promised land. You want to replace him. Are you stupid? Join and fight and make sure our leader is released and therefore is restored. Stop following all these mushroom gossiping agents to destabilize the coming of Biafra. The more you do that, as I said, and that is a fact from the ministry, we are the only people that is going to stop Biafra coming. Nobody is going to give us Biafra. We have to fight for it. And before I hand over back to you, I want to thank those of our Biafra women that gathered in UK to protest for the past 3 days. Kudos to me. We have made Biafra proud. And we are glad to call you our mothers. And may you come and guide every one of you. And return every one of you back to where you came from, settled. Mazo Bino, I thank you for giving me this opportunity this evening. I will pay the way for others to speak. Thank you very much.
Mazo, thank you very much. But before you go, I really want you to hold on. There is something that, you know, that is something that has been swirling, so that I will want you to shed light on, because, you know, our people that want to, you know, they want to get answers in everything they think is bothering them, or anything they think is disturbing them, they want to get answers to it. So I want to like ask you like one or two questions before I let you go this morning.
You can ask me any question, just go ahead.
Alright, I'm going to start with the one. Yesterday, there is a man that called Radio Biafra, and he was complaining about how IPOB, we have Ebonized it, and I just want to bring it out so that, you know, it will be touch of it, but that is not the real question that I want to ask. He said we shouldn't Ebonize Biafra or IPOB. Also, the question there is the radio on Riverline area. You know, he complained about it bitterly, and I want to bring it to you. And also, you know, I just want to add it to you, because if I will make it one question, maybe it will take us time. And also, you know, I've been hearing kind of murmuring that let me just allow you to deal with this one of the radio.
I will start with demonizing. When someone said demonizing is generalizing, that is a false statement. Radio Biafra is equal. It's Radio Biafra is meant for all the world Biafrans. Everyone can call it. Not only that, everyone can call into Radio Biafra. We have how many states that make up clans? It's more than 14 or so. And in Radio Biafra, we have people that are not evil that are broadcasting, that are River Line as well. And we always advocated for our people from Riverline to join what we are doing, because we are the same. Nobody is killing anybody, nobody is moving anywhere. That's why I said it's a false statement. The Riverline, they have a push here like every one of us. They have to determine to choose the both referendum is the one to be part of Biafra. That is number one law. Number two is everybody is equal. When you say Ibonize, that is a false statement. What you're saying is those that are calling, we shouldn't call. We should allow those from other area to call. How can we control that? It doesn't make sense. It will make sense when you say that, in what we are doing, we are excluding our brothers from Riverland. But in this case, we do not. All we do here, we encourage people to call a radio member. We encourage people from Riverland to come up and join what we are doing. You can take a horse to the river, but you cannot force the horse to drink. But they are doing what they are doing. Because the difference is that we are more, Igbos are more of our side than Zoo. And we are more vocal call than them. We do call. So that is a completely wrong statement. I'm not sure what else he wants us to do. Is he want people, not ban people out if you are able, if you answer any good and do that for a good job? Then you are doing something different. In Biafra, everything is based on merit. Everything is flat. That's why we have a leader said it. In every clan, they have their own parliament, their own language, they make their own rules, they make their own law that we govern them. They grow at their own pace. So no one will say it's a minority in some father's land. That is the difference between us and the current Zoo. Coming to the radio. If you are doing that, it's our people and some from IPOB, people from abroad and other things from radio. Some of us, Igbos actually, the main radio for read around all these areas. So in essence, is Igbo people are donating to Riverline? How many of the Riverline are come out and donate radio from their own community? So that person does not know what he or she is talking about. Our policy is to make sure radio is covered every corner. It's people like this, I'm not sure if you say this with a good paper, it doesn't know or those who want to instigate the problem. But it's always good for someone to understand things before they say it. I wouldn't say it's instigating something because I don't know where it's coming from, but the radio. He said, mostly ours, we organize and raise money and put radios in our community. Those areas can equally do the same. But some of us actually donate radio to those communities as well. So when we say things are equal, but at the same time we help an area we can, I think we are balanced. We are not partial.
Thank you very much. I am so glad that you're seeing this on air and Biafrans, they are listening to you. And I wanted to attach it to what you, the question that you've answered already, but I'm going to bring it anyway. You know, there are this murmuring and rumor. I will not call it rumor, but it has been swirling for a very, very long time now, which I'm going to bring to you. You know, they used to say, before I say it, I want to say what our sister FA, that was one of the answers she gave to Mazike Chukwuonoha on the day she grant interview to Mazike Chukwuonoha. Mazike Chukwuonoha asked her about those people saying things about Riverline areas. Her response was, any fallen angels will always come back with Riverline area because he said any fallen angel from IPOB, they will come back and say it is the Riverline area people we are marginalized, that IPOB is marginalizing them. So that was what she said. So what I want to ask now is, what exactly or what criteria or what do an individual need to meet, what anybody that wants to work for Biafra right now, what is the criteria that this person need to reach or meet for that person to be able to work for Biafra? Because it is part of the question that I asked already. They said in IPOB, it is one set of people that are controlling the radio. Please, what do you have to say about this?
One statement, someone making that statement is a jealous mess and envy. Because the envy of this company cannot be somebody, because that person is nobody. Because you can only be happy of yourself before you can be blessed to be more. But if you envy of other people who are not even a think or recognize this, you are just giving yourself a hard attack. Using the river Nile area as a punch pad, again, it's one where it's a dose that, as our leader always said, if you see a beautiful girl, you don't know what to get, I just have to go and have a child. So they don't have anything to say, they're just looking for putting it around the problem. We have a lot of you expect to see the good man. When you remove the flesh, you can see their spirit, you can see actually who they are. That is it. So they are planted, waiting for that time, for them to strike, and that is what they are doing at this very moment. There is a Bible told us in the book of life, there is a role in heaven. The fourth one is heaven. So what about earth? Earth is here. It's all. There is one in the world. So one should not be surprised when you see people like this surfacing, making all this false accusation of crime. And again, people that you regard as a human being, as a respected someone, part-talking crap. Just know who they are. They are those devils waiting for the appropriate capital power to showcase who they are. If you take out the skin, the flesh, if you go to the down into the spirit, you see who they are. They are that agent. Some of them are thieves, some of them are all kinds of animals. They are the agents. Yes. It's a gift to detect all these people. It might not make sense to anybody that we are hearing it for the first time, but this is fact. That's why I keep on saying that the problem with our people is when somebody says, oh, Biafra, you guys took like a beam following him. And so he started saying, when I get to the wedding, then he said, oh, it's not castigated. But yeah, the people that first are following him like a beam. Because we love gossiping. That's why we going through. And then when you receive the disappointment, you come back and say, oh, I'm confused. But you're still confused. You know where you get your source information. If you don't go there to get their information, then it's your fault. So that is what I have to say.
Thank you very much. Thank you very, very much. You know, this one has to do with those that call them with a lecturer and IPOB. So I don't really go into what this man said. Anyway, I'm going to call his name for people to understand and for you to understand exactly who said what he said. It is about this man he called Ifeanyi Uba. He granted an interview on BBC Igbo. Everything he was saying, he said it in Igbo language. He said so many things. But what I want to pinch out of what he said was, IPOB said that there will be election. So that is what I'm taking, or what that is what I'm pinching out of every single thing he has said, because that is what I think is consigning us, and we must set the record straight. He said, I think he is referring to Imapa Ofu, the secretary of IPOB, media personnel of IPOB. Yes. So he said that IPOB said there will be election. So that is the reason why I decide to bring it to you this morning. So that you clarify it, so that Biafrans all over the world will know and know how these people are lying against us. Please, Mazi, go ahead.
Yes, we have served so many times IPOB, because if you look at what is going on in Anambra State, it's become a gang state. The actors are killing themselves. IPOB has not yet made any official statement regarding Anambra State. IPOB publicity secretary have not yet released any press statement regarding Anambra State election. Ifeanyi Uba is a politician. He desperately wants to go to Anambra State to vote. Spoil whatever left. We all know who Ifeanyi Uba is. These people do not speak to us, and they do not represent us. All they represent is their own interest, and the interest of caliphate. And in due time, IPOB will release official statement regarding Anambra election. And IPOB will do it as its own convenient time. Remember, we set an agenda. Zoom the budget set agenda for us. IPOB do not do this out of emotion. IPOB sit down and study and pick the right decision. We don't do this based on emotion. You cannot continue and then want and expect different result. And this is the reason the people trust in us. And we must continue to maintain that trust. Because it's hard to bend that. One thing we are showing them is, IPOB and DOS has no business with any politicians in this. Yes. Doesn't matter all this head agent are talking. All their cohort making all this so big. Telling us to them. IPOB high like officer, even they do not have any business, any Zoom politician. Because we know who they represent. If we give them any opportunity, they will wipe out everybody that is in the East to please their master. We already, before they came, we know who they are. So that's why it's our duty to make sure we never allow them to have them. It doesn't matter how sweet. It doesn't matter what come out of them. Everything that comes out of their mouth is said is evil.
Thank you very much, that's all.
Alright, thank you very much, Nazi. Thank you very, very much for clarifying that. And the whole world is seeing how these people are lying. How they are lying. But Chukwu Kikeabiama is in heaven. He is watching. Alright, Nazi, this minute I will say peace. A word of advice for Biafran because of what is happening in our land. Whatever way you can advise Biafran's please do, and your closing remark will be a prayer for Israel. Please, go ahead.
Okay, thank you very much. My advice for us is, Biafran's, we, many of us are scared of the rest of leader has in mind. What I have to say this evening is that we must continue to read this act of faith. We must continue to do what God's IPB asks us to do. It's for our own collective interest. Everybody is under the protection of their first respond in the truth and in honesty. One thing we will not do is to come on this platform lying to our people. Because if we do that, God Kagame will depart from us. I am not joking. I've seen it. I've seen the warning repeatedly. That is the truth. Whatever we say, if we say this is not it, this is not possible, we tell our people it's not possible. It doesn't matter how bitter it is, but we have to tell our people. And that is what we are always to be. We always get a backlash, that is fine, it's normal. But we cannot think or make people's claim of things that is not true. And when you see us attacking people saying that is not true, we try to say the record straight because there is no need of hiding the emotion, the expectation, and then the next day, it happened that it's all false. It's like a fantasy, utopian life, it doesn't mean nothing. We are just hiding ourselves like someone on board when the drug clear up, then we will come back to reality. This is not the better way to see. The road is hard. But there is one thing we have promised, that the effort will be restored, the victory is ours. But how we get here is something that we have to endure. Men and women are going to die. Those that are not to die are going to die. Those that are going to live are going to live. But it's the duty of me and you to make sure we continue to push forward. Now we never betray this struggle. Because if we do that, we pay with our generation. It doesn't matter who that person is. Even those that still work in our ESM fund money, if you don't release that money, calamity can come upon you and your generation. This book that then I will say that. Nobody does anything that could be just touch free. Our land, I always say our land, like they told us we do not have history. They use that to deceive us. Yes, as I can tell you, our land has become back, our land has been healed. Because everyone does follow that person. That's why I live there, they say, if we have it can do it, you have nothing yet. Envy and jealousness, you cannot do what our leader is doing. He sat on teacher for how many months now? Where are those people? You cannot find them. Because nobody can do what he's doing. The same thing. All they are good at is to bring him down. Pull him down. Our leader is not there. All these things, you know, they are always in here. Two of their front group. I haven't seen any of them coming up. IPAB is here. We mind our business. We do our own thing. Still, they don't want to go and have their own and do this thing. They do what they want to do. They still want to come and pull IPAB down. Did you see what I said? The devil is in us. It's living and breathing among us. I that if you don't like what I put is then you go and start your own and do it better. No. The assignment, you have to listen very carefully. The assignment is to pull IPOB down. And you are supporting them. They are saying, go ahead, we support you. We are saying the truth. Just examine what Fulanese did to Yoruba. I mean, did to Fulani, Hausa people. Fulani did to Fulani. Fulani did to Hausa people. When they are entering the food, they came to teach in the palace of Hausa kingdom. They convinced the king, oh, they are corrupt. Yeah, some of them are willing to come and fight the corruption. And then what happens? There is what? Fulani can Hausa people help to Fulani, they kill their own. And then Fulani take over. This is exactly what is prepared to do with IPOB. As I said, at the zoo, it wasn't hidden. We made an announcement. They brought money to the stabilized IPOB meeting. Their first assignment is to bring somebody, say, oh, he's taking over from Radio Biafra. When that one fell, they went to Nemaya, said Nemaya heard that ESM money doesn't want to release this force. He heard this money, all those things is false. Our leader knows all about it, but our leader told him what to do before our leader was arrested. They make up all this a false accusation. When that one fell, they said that was a cheap negotiator. If I jump on, they are corrupt, they are compromised. They move to the next one. That one fell as well. Now they say China and who other people, they also they are genocide. They are moving from one agenda to the other. And then their cohort, they are making audios from under their bed, using the fox net, trying looking for people to devour. Are you following me? They didn't use their false prophet, pay them money. The way they did this, they planned it very, very well. Before our leader was arrested, that's why he's arrested, if you do not know. Yes. From every indication, they are, they're planning. They're part and parcel. You ask how? How we explain? Because it's a common sense. I will use a couple of references to draw your attention. Before I leave, this thing happened. Every prophet was prophesizing that somebody was a woman, going to be trial. Who told a good prophet? Mary and cohort. Who sent money to a leader in Mary in Kenya? The same group of people. But in Mary, they did not know where our leader was. They didn't know he was in Kenya. They were accusing a poor woman. Are you following me? So, they put all this in place. And then wrote a very nice script. Now, Rita was scared. He rise up like a Elisha. He's in a new flesh. He's crying and all those things. The same set of people went and reported ESM account in America. Turn around and listed certain people, said they are the people that reported the account. The reason I said they are the people that did that is because we told them what to do to get a report from the bank. They refused to do that. We said, subpoena the bank. They didn't. Well, they use a lawyer to write our sister member to the great office in Germany. I said, oh, so you have a lawyer. Well, didn't use that lawyer to take the bank to the court to provide the document to report it at our ESM account. Are you following me? You see the plus? Because they already collected money. And the before all these things happening, we have already met some people in IPOB, in the media as well, giving them money. They give their media group, and they're giving their retired money card, preparing them for the queue. And they have people that are giving them information. The reason I don't want to call them now is I don't want to make them popular. But the reason I'm following what is happening here and some of this going on. Waiting, and then I will not have to come out and say that, oh, these people reported their account because they're waiting for the perfect time. Please don't give us it because we are smart. To revive the emotion, our emotion, our heart is like a stone. We don't have the emotion is dried up 20 years ago. So we work on the reality. They couldn't. Everything is a false accusation. Now, if they love our leader through the law, said, let there be a peace. And they say, stop to them, stop. They don't want to stop. Every day they are releasing every balance of this accusation, every day, stop. If you so love what we are doing, you love Mazin and the candle, and you love him so dear, when he told you to stop, you can stop. Just like in the Bible, Solomon, when a woman came to him and said, my friend of the child, then that child belongs to me, now said, belongs to me. Then the woman said, oh, divide them. Then the woman said, no, leave the man, let her know his child, when the child grew up, he's never losing. He is actually the owner. Very simple, that showing this person, that woman, yes, it's my son, I don't want anything happening. We can wait. If they are so loved our leaders, we said they wait. They would have waited and calmed down and spoken. But no, they are on a time schedule to the visa, so they can get their money. That is why they are pushing everything. That is why they attack our finance in Ghana, because when you destabilize the finance, when the money is coming, when you don't have the confidence, the people doesn't have the confidence to send money to Ghana, where we are being returned. Then who stop where we are being? We, as always said, we are the people that are going to stop the coming of the Biafra, nobody else. Are you following me? Because it's there, it's like a damn light. We are the people that is going to stop what we are doing. So you see how they thought that they are smart. They can work with people's intelligence. To bring a confidence, our money that is sponsored to them without flaws. Gambling Sendema is our chief finance officer. So she can have access to any of our accounts. And she follows instruction from her leader, from nobody else. So if I like, I can tell her whatever she wants. She's not going to listen to me. And that is what is happening. So this woman, they are, is Jezebel, part two. The house of Jezebel. Because they came to devour. They came to destroy. And it's unfortunate that they have met some people that are like them. As I said, if you go beyond their skin, go into their spirit, they are the same thing. The process for them like this. Today, what is happening is your death will come. It didn't start happening by accident. It was a death. But what is paramount is the difference. We must continue pushing. Victory is ours. The world can be won. And we're going to defeat all of them anyway. So if you defeat them from here, they move to the next one, creating a confusion because they run out of idea. That is what is going on.
So before I move, I want to thank the Biafra and Friends of Biafra. When we took Kadiam, we are the children of the light. We are the salt of the earth. Only if we know who we are. Our land is the epic center. That is the cardinal point. That is the zero altitude, as I said before. That is the beginning of the civilization. That's why the the civilization started in our land. Yeah, that our land is at the garden of Eden. Our land is home. We must return back to who we are. That is only way forward. If you look back to the people of all over the world, those that are doing well, they are following the God of their life, and our own will not be different. I'm glad we have been waking up. Our leader Mazinda Mikana has opened our eyes, and we are seeing it. As I said earlier, Melicha and Melena is a two-step character. You cannot mix both. And one will not replace the other. And we said that depending on the way we can all the whole world you have know, every country, they have their own gods. And they give those gods what they want. And that is why they continue the process. But in our own land, we are abandoning our own God because we can't hear it. And giving praises to another God. How can we progress in a simple time? Below, we are father. We are, for example, we are father born and ready to tell children. They walk hard and grow and they grow up and become an adult. So the demons or the leaders come and go outside and die. Whenever they went to when they are, they want to thank this to their father from the city. Father, they adopted their father, somebody, they said this person, another person is their father, abandoning their biological father. So every time they go to him and give him something, they say, Father, this they give to the father, they are adopted their father, and abandoning their biological father. And then when you lay down at night, you say, Father, bless me, you are Mogazian. You are asking that your adopted father to consider you. Your biological father, that raised you up, you're not possible day in and day night. Are you going to progress on the land? The answer is no. We have our brother. It's simple, very simple. Not the way if somebody do it to you. You'll be very, very angry. You'll be very, very disordered. So that is what has happened. So you disown yours and yours. And you can disown it. And that is why foreigners are taking over our man. Amen. Thank you very much, Mazodi. I'll
end my participation this evening so I can take away. I don't know how many hours left for us to contribute.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
So
thank you
for continuing to bless and continue to bless our family in Israel. Yes, and our leader was coming out of the zoo before they meet our leader. What will happen on the zoo? Next Shabbat, we tell them what is going to happen to the zoo if they do not. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. And you too. Thank you very, very much. May Chukwuma bless you and your families as well. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.